All right, we're here with head coach Alaura Sharp after tonight's 56-53 defeat to Hampton. Coach, just overall thought it was a good fourth quarter rally, but kind of just fell behind the eight ball early there in the first two quarters.
Yeah, I mean, obviously proud of the fourth quarter and how we finished the game. We had a lot of opportunity to kind of quit and throw the towel in, and I thought we really battled back and fought back and gave ourselves a chance to win at the end. You know, frustrated with the last kind of couple possessions there, but you know, winning basketball is four quarters, and we had 17 turnovers in the first half. We threw the ball literally all over the gym. I thought we responded a little bit in the third quarter as far as coming out and playing stronger with the basketball. It's just, as a coach, it's just crazy. You're running the same offense, you're doing the same things, you're seeing the same defense, and you're able to take care of the basketball just by settling down and executing. And you know, the message to him is I felt like we sleptwalked through the first couple, two and a half quarters, and it's just not that time of year to be doing that. And it's just important for us to learn those lessons before it's too late. You know, I thought Malia responded. You know, I kind of challenged her coming out of a timeout. I thought she gave up on a play, got scored on when she missed the shot, and I thought she came out really rallied down the stretch. But, you know, defensively, Nyla Young is a really good player. And she is a beast in the paint. And, you know, Hampton's got really good players. And they made some good plays on the stretch. And it's a tough matchup for us. But, you know, just looking for us to correct some of those things.
You touched on Malia Bercone, career high 19. And then also Lamisha Madden had career high as well tonight. What did you see out of those two? I know you mentioned Lamisha on Saturday had a nice game. It didn't show up in the stats, but the stats bear it out tonight for her.
Yeah, I thought Mimi played really well on Saturday. And, you know, I thought she kind of kept us alive offensively in the first half. She hit a couple of threes. I mean, had we not have those, you know, we're sitting at really short points at halftime. So I was proud of that effort. You know, same thing with Malia. I thought she really exploded in the fourth quarter. I think a lot of those points probably came in the fourth quarter. I thought she was really, really aggressive and played really confident in the fourth quarter.
It's a quick turnaround, like we discussed, about 48 hours till we got back-to-backs here with A&T. How do we kind of just move on to this next one? And you get the same team here in Greensboro Thursday, then back here on Saturday.
I mean, the same way you move on from every game, win or loss. You know, you show up tomorrow and you go to class and you do what you're supposed to do and you study and you do your work and you come down and you sit and film and you take notes and you learn from your mistakes and you learn how you can be a little more coachable, how we can be a little bit better teammates, how can we execute a little bit better, how can we guard just a little bit better, and you just keep doing what you're doing as a staff. Same thing, we just got to keep investing in our kids. We have all the tools we need to be successful. We have enough talent, we have enough toughness, but it's just about putting that stuff together for 40 minutes.
Appreciate it, Coach.
Thank you.